enter through the narrow gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate, and narrow is the road that leads to life, and only a few find it. Watch out for false prophets. They come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ferocious wolves.
Joseph Sr. considered his money digging an occupation, and often brought Joseph Jr. with him on his expeditions. This involved special rituals and ceremonies which were performed for the purpose of obtaining buried treasure. It is through these expeditions that Joseph found his beloved seer stone, which he used to try to locate treasures of gold and silver. Joseph would place his magical rock into a hat and pull the hat up to his face to block out all light. By doing this, he claimed he could see supernaturally.
Can you keep a secret?
Well, sure I can.
I have, in my possession, an ancient book written on gold plates that tells of Jesus Christ's second coming. Here, in America.
In America? Really? That sounds kind of... Dum, dum, dum,
dum, dum. It's true, and I'm going to translate the plates and publish it into a book for the whole world to read. Now, I know you have a lot of money, Mr. Harris, and I'm just going to need a little bit to pay for the publishing costs.
I don't know. How do you expect to translate?
With these.
Rocks?
They're not rocks. They're seer stones, given to me by an angel. With them, God allowed me to translate the plates into English. Watch. You take this quill and paper and write down what I say. Sit here. I have the golden plates here in this hat. I need to have them somewhere dark so I can read the spiritual light.
Really?
Now, when I put the seer stones into the hat, the ancient letters light up and change to English, which I can then read to you.
Smith put his head into a hat and read to me what the golden plate said. I wrote it all down and we're going to publish it into a book.
Martin went home to his wife, dum 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 dum, and showed her pages from the Book of Mormon, dum 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 dum.
And so Joseph Smith put his head into a hat and read to me what the golden plate said. I wrote it all down and we're going to publish it into a book.
Martin, how do you know he isn't just making stuff up and pretending he's translating off golden plates?
Lucy Harris, smart, 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 smart.
Why would he make it up?
Martin Harris, dum-da-dum.
All right, here. I'm gonna hide these pages. If Joseph Smith really is translating off of golden plates, then he'll be able to do it again. But if Joseph Smith is making it all up, then the new translations will be different from these.
Okay, fine. I bet he'll have no problem.
Lucy Harris, smart, 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 Martin Harris, dumb. So Martin went on back to Smith, said the pages had gone away. Smith got mad and told Martin he needed to go pray. Dum, 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 dum.
Look, I'm sorry about losing the pages we worked on, Joe, but I'm ready to write it all down again if you translate from the plates.
I would love to, Martin. Except, I just had a vision, and the Lord said he is very angry with me for letting you take those pages.
He is?
Dum, 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 dum.
Yes, he is so mad that he will never let me translate from the plate of Lehi again. He said we must now translate from the plate of Nephi. So it will be the same basic story, but written a little differently.
Wow! God got angry with you, then you must be telling the truth.
Dum, 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 dum.
How it happened.
Yeah!
Wait, Mormons actually know this story and they still believe Joseph Smith was a prophet?
Well, sure. The story proves it, doesn't it?
No, it proves he did make it all up. Are you blind?
Well, Stan, it's all a matter of faith.
No, it's a matter of logic. If you're gonna say things that have been proven wrong, like that the first man and woman lived in Missouri and that Native Americans came from Jerusalem, then you better have something to back it up. All you've got
with our religion.
I don't want to be Mormon, Dad!
You said they're really trying to follow Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
So why don't you follow Jesus Christ and not the Book of Mormon?
Because I prayed about the Book of Mormon and I got to know that this is true.
You just said I tried to follow Jesus Christ, don't follow the Book of Mormon.
Because the Book of Mormon testifies of Jesus Christ.
All it says in the Book of Mormon, it says we prophesy of Christ, and we rejoice in Christ, and we preach of Christ, so that we may know what's looked for the remission of our sins.
It contradicts the Bible.
Where does it contradict?
You're saying that Jesus is Satan's brother. I'll tell you the contradictions, that's one. There's another one that you think God is a man and he's on this place now.
And the Bible teaches, that's where we get that from.
God is in heaven.
If
you follow Christ, chuck the Book of Mormon away.
Why? The Book of Mormon, how it says on the cover, it's another testimony of Jesus Christ. It basically just helped us to know Jesus Christ more and what he taught the people. Why do you think Jesus Christ would only teach a bunch of people? We say that he loves everybody. His teaching is love everybody. Like you love yourself. And why he would only reveal his truth to one part of the earth? Why don't you think he would reveal the truth to every man on the earth?
It is being revealed. Do you know the Bible, yeah? The Bible is the first book ever to be printed.
Yeah.
The first book ever to be printed. The most ever printed and sold book.
Yeah.
I mean ever.
Yeah,
like billions and billions of copies have been made.
And there is a lot of truth inside of the Bible.
It's the most book that's been produced in as many languages. There's over 66 books, over 40 different authors, over 3 continents, Asia, Europe and Africa, in 3 languages, Hebrew, Aramaic and Greek. It's been the circulation, no other book has been mass produced other than the Bible. No other book apart from the Holy Bible tells you perfect sense, black and white. Compare that to the Book of Mormon. The Book of Mormon is not.
Book of Mormon supports all that.
Not even on the scale to that.
I'll tell you how it compares to the Book of Mormon. How many times that's been translated? And to think, if a prophet who had, you know, a seer or a revelator, if they were able to take Aramaic and translate that to English, it would be a lot clearer than what it is right now. Instead, it was scholars like Constantine put things together, all these people. But Joseph Smith had the records of the Book of Mormon. They were revealed to him. And he took it from that language to modern-day English and to everything else.
Angel.
Do you believe in angels? It's in Revelation, but it speaks of angels.
I believe in angels, but I also believe that Satan masquerades as an angel.
We do as well, and we believe that you have to ask the angel to hold your hand, shake your hand, and if it doesn't shake your hand, if it shakes your hand and you can't feel anything, that's how you know it's an angel of darkness. Because they don't have a bottom.
Demons can lie, man.
And you know what else can lie?
Demons can lie.
The Bible can lie to you if the way you interpret it.
Nah. Not with God on my side, man. You're going to go to outer darkness.
We believe it's in the Bible which says that if we suffer with Christ, we may also be glorified together. What was Jesus Christ's glory?
He
became the Son of God. He inherited all the gods had. So if we suffer with Christ and inherit the same glory as it says in Romans 8:17, that would mean that we inherit the same glory as Christ. What would that be? Eternal life.
To
be like God and Jesus Christ.
No, you do not become God. There is only one God. That's another contradiction you just brought up. You believe that when you come to heaven, you attain godhood. But the Lord said, I am the Lord your God. There is no other God besides me.
Explain that. There's no other God before me, but what's behind him?
Nah, I am the Lord your God. There is no other God besides me.
In Genesis it says, let us go down. Who's us? Let us go down.
Jesus and God and angels.
So Jesus and God are both gods. So they're us.
No, you're not God.
Jesus and God are angels, right?
Huh?
Jesus and God are both gods.
Yeah.
Alright, so if they said let us go down, for there's, you know, let us make man in our image, our, that's plural. So they're speaking of gods. Because Jesus Christ was foreordained, so he was a god before he even came to this.
See, this is what I'm getting to. This is where the Book of Mormon is just polluting your mind.
The Book of Mormon doesn't teach any of this.
It teaches that you become God. You attain godhood. I'll just quote that.
The Book of Mormon helps what you are wanting. It's what for people to believe in Christ. The Book of Mormon proves to people who are non-believers that Jesus Christ appeared to ancient American people.
I was taking you through him, but he just kept saying, like, the Book of Mormon teaches
all of these I've disproved many times, and you don't want to accept the facts that are in the Bible.
You don't want to accept that you're not going to become God. There's only one God, yeah? And it's Jesus Christ, and God, and the Holy Spirit.
So where's the authority of God, then?
In the Bible. Everywhere in the Bible,
the Bible does not give authority, though. It said, no man taketh this honor unto himself except he that is called of God as his Aaron. Moses was the brother of Aaron. And he passed that authority on by the laying on of hands, just like Jesus Christ put his hands upon his apostles' head. He gave them the priesthood authority.
So apparently these guys put their hands on Joseph Smith's head. But you ain't got no proof.
Peter, James, and John.
You ain't got no proof that this
We have two witnesses,
happened.
Joseph Smith and Oliver Cowdery. All right. Well, thank you for your time.
Can I pray for you? Would you be embarrassed if I'd done that?
No, I'll pray anywhere.
No? Come here then.
We'll pray together like this.
No, let me pray for you guys, yeah? Yeah? All right. No. You got bow your heads and close your eyes. I'm sorry, bro.
What is that?
What?
I don't know.
This is praying on, right?
Huh?
Go for it.
You need to pray.